So students, we will be moving to our next section, which is course objective number 2, which is types and design of welded joints. In welding engineering, the concept of welding design encompasses a broad range of subjects that include weld and joint types, economics, weld sizing for various loading conditions, symbols, quality and testing, residual stresses and distortion, along with heat flow. However, for the sake of simplicity of the subject, we will be covering only the types of joints as well as the design for welded joints. Joint types. Joint types basically refers to how two workpieces being welded are oriented relative to each other, and weld type refers to the way the weld is placed in the joint. Since we know that weld is basically a permanent union between materials caused by heat and or pressure, there are basically two main types of weld: fillet weld and groove weld. But there are other approaches as well, such as slot weld, seam weld, spot weld, stud weld, etc. However, amongst the two main types of weld, fillet weld are those that are placed in a corner formed by two mating workpieces, whereas, as the name implies, groove welds are those that are placed in the grooves. The term weld joint design refers to the way pieces of metal are put together or aligned with each other. And the configuration of these members are basically 5 types: butt weld, T-lap, joint, corner and edge. In some of these pictures, you can see the orientation plane for butt joint, corner joint, T-joint, lap joint and edge joint. It is a very good example of basically the types of joint which are can be seen in this picture, and you can see that all 5 types of joint are present in the picture. So basically, when we are welding two materials, the surface which are to be joined or which are welded are called a fang surface, and there can be some preparations which can be carried out on those surface. We can prepare the edges which we are going to weld, and the reasons for preparing those edges is that for sometimes we want to increase the strength of the weld, sometimes we want deeper penetration, smoother appearance, etc. So based on the type and shape of the surface preparation, there are various types of shapes. For instance, you can see we have got a square. This is the most simplest part of joint. Then we've got V joint, double V joint, which is on both sides of the weld. Then bevel is a single kind of a chamfer on inclined plane. Then we've got double bevel. Then we've got J. Then we've got a single J, double U, double J, etc. So these are basically the types of edges which can be prepared for welding joint design. So these are some different types of edges which have been prepared for butt joint and fillet lap welded joints. So for figure number 1, on your left side, you can see different types of butt joints, and then they have been prepared differently for their edges preparation. The reason for doing the edges preparation for butt joint is that we want the groove to have a required strength or a good strength. And then we need to make sure that the groove angle must be sufficient to allow the electrode into the joint. So you basically want the electrode to basically go into the joint. Otherwise, what will happen is that there will be lack of penetration, or there might be chances for cracking. And then what we need to make sure is that we cannot make the chamfer too high. So increasing the chamfering angle, which is also called the beveling. So basically that chamfer that V is called a bevel, and excessive beveling basically causes a waste of material and time. Let's move on to the fillet weld. For fillet weld, basically the strength of the weld depends on the size of fillet, and this is very important that there can be a single fillet and double side fillet, slant fillet, or all way around a side fillet, which can be seen in figure B. In another example, you can see three types of T joint in the blue color. One is one fillet weld T-joint on both sides. Then I can prepare T-joint using a bed weld, and then I can use both fillet and bed weld, which is called a compound welded T-joint. So these are different configuration, different joint design, different edge preparation which can be used. And here are some examples for corner joints, T-joints and edge joints. For edge joints, basically these joints are mainly used to join edges of sheet metals. They are used to reinforce flanges of I-beams and mufflers. So this was all about welding joint design, joint types and edges preparation, etc. Next we are going to move to welding positions.